In this video, I demonstrate how I treat asymmetric tonic neck reflex, which is called ATNR. This is one of primitive reflex which children has to have. Let's check the test. Now I ask him to turn neck this way. I want you to focus on how far his finger moves. Now, if this is negative, his fingers should not move. Let's see, I'm gonna point it. You see how far he moves his fingers? This is positive. I'm gonna ask him again. Now his finger moves about 2 cm, 3 cm, or 1 inch. Let's do a treatment. This is how I do a treatment for primitive reflex. I'm going to explain later. If people have ATNR, they tend to have learning disability. Good, his body starts reacting. I'm gonna test again. Let's check his finger movement. Not much, but 1 cm. Goodness. I'm doing same thing, treatment of reflex. Let's check again. Barely, his finger barely moves, but 5 mm. This is good improvement. So I'm going to explain how this ATNR affect ADHD. Now, why ATNR is related to ADHD? I'm gonna explain why. Basically, ATNR is when I look this way, right side, my right arm wants to extend. If I want to go this way, my left side stretches like this, bow and arrow kind of looking. So why is this important? So if I have, let's say if I have ATNR, I don't want to cross my midline. I want to go this way, like same side, I want to do this way, I don't want to go this way. Why is it important for learning environment? I'm gonna explain why. Say, I'm in the classroom taking class. So this way is teacher is going this way and blackboard is this way. Usually students are supposed to sit this way, square up and write, read, right? But if I have ATNR, I don't want to cross my midline, like writing this way or reading my eyes going this way. I don't want to cross my midline. So what do children do not crossing midline? They do this. Why? Because my midline is this way, so I don't cross midline to write or read. So if children are sitting this way, or writing this way, they may have ATNR. So ATNR can affect both writing and reading. Why? Because whatever you write, English or Japanese or Chinese, they have to cross midline eventually, right? Going to this way or side to side, they have to cross midline when they write. Or reading, either it's going this way or sideways, my eyes have to cross my midline, but they don't want to do it. So if people have ATNR, they don't like reading and writing. So this is why ATNR can affect ADHD. So this is it. If you liked this video, please like, comment, and subscribe.